Man, the mosquitoes are bad.
Golly, they're bad. Every time I hit record. Golly, these mosquitoes are killing me. All right, y'all. Today I'm going to talk just a little bit about milkweed. Milkweed has become pretty popular here in the past few years among deer hunters as a wind indicator. Basically, what it is just a seed pod full of seeds that are attached to very fine silk. And you take a piece of silk and throw it, and it travels with the wind. It goes up, it goes down, and you can see it a long ways and tell exactly what the wind is doing. Really helpful when you're deer hunting, and especially getting close to deer bedding, where you want to make sure that wind is not swirling around carrying your scent back to the deer. So anyway, we're going to talk about what it looks like and where to find it. Common milkweed is probably the largest. It is native to the United States. And these are the seed pods that are not ripe yet. When they ripen here in about a month or two, or probably less because these are already getting big, when they ripen they turn brown, and then this seam down the middle splits open, and then all the silk starts to disperse and carry the seeds away. Now notice the milky white sap all over my hands. That's why it's called milkweed. So this is what you're looking for, is common milkweed. Now there are a couple other kinds of milkweed that are native here in the United States that you may find as well. There's swamp milkweed, which, unlike this, which grows on a single stalk, swamp milkweed is more bushy and has multiple stems, and it has more narrow leaves and smaller, more narrow pods. And then of course there's butterfly weed, which is only about this tall. And it's got bright orange flowers. It's real pretty, but it's a really small milkweed and the pods are tiny. So for the purpose of deer hunting and having a wind indicator, you're looking for the big common milkweed. This is about average height right here. It's usually about 4 feet tall, give or take. It grows in full sun mostly. If you do find it growing in a shaded area, it usually doesn't put out pods very well because it needs full sun to produce fruit. So what you're looking for is fields just like this. Notice this field has not been cut all year, and that's important to note because if they cut hay or bush hog a field during the summer, that milkweed is going to have to start its growth all over again from the roots, and it probably won't have time to make mature pods before the frost hits in the fall. It is a perennial. It grows back from the same rootstock every year, so in the wintertime this whole plant dies off. After the pods split off, then the whole plant dies when the frost hits. But the root stays alive, and next year it'll grow back in the exact same spot. You can check fields like this that are overgrown that have not been cut in a while. You can also just drive down the highway and check the edges of the roads where they don't cut very often. Now I've seen a lot of people online say they can't find it or it doesn't grow in their area. And then there's some people who say, if you can't find it, you're not looking hard enough. It grows everywhere. Well, both sides can be true depending on where you're at. And I'm putting a link down below in the description to the USDA website. And what they have there is a distribution map that shows all the states highlighted in green that have milkweed, where milkweed has been documented. And if you take that map and zoom in to your state, you can see every county. And those individual counties are highlighted in green where milkweed has been documented. I can say for a fact there is one county in my home state that has a lot of milkweed that is not highlighted in green. So even if it doesn't show for your county, if you've got two or three surrounding counties that have it, it's probably growing in your county as well. So check out that link below if you want to get an idea of if it actually grows in your area. So with that said, if it doesn't grow in your area, there's always people online willing to help out on the Facebook groups, on forums, or you can use cotton balls if you don't want to go through the hassle. I heard the cotton balls work well, cattail fluff works well, and cottonwood trees, which are already done by now, but if you get early enough, you can get the fuzz off cottonwood trees as well. But here in the fall, when we go into bow season, that's when the milkweed pods are ripening, and a lot of the places I hunt, I can literally pick pods on my way into the woods to go hunt and put them in my pocket, and I can have wind checkers for the whole hunt. So, again, check out the link below and look at the map, look at your state, zoom in on the map and see if milkweed is found in your area. And if it is, this is the type of habitat you find it growing in. Well, hopefully y'all found that helpful. If you got any questions, just drop them down below and I'll try and answer. And I hope all of you have a great deer season.